is an avid gamer waging war on software piracy. The Intellectual Property Office of the Philippines said counterfeit and piracy reports spiked by nearly 4 times in the first half of the year. Of the 200 reports it received, 152 were piracy concerns, nearly all of which came from just one individual. The internet user filed 135 complaints over pirated gaming software, leading the agency to believe the complainant is an avid gamer. IPO PHL Director General Roel Barba commended concerned netizens for reporting such cases. He also reiterated the call for intellectual property holders to enforce their rights more actively.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s trip to Malaysia yields $285 million worth of investment pledges for the Philippines. Malacanang says Malaysian business leaders are interested in investing in food processing, multi-service digital platforms, and aviation, among others. President Marcos also assured Malaysian investors of his administration's support.
The engagement with Malaysian companies and business leaders this morning yielded very interesting and what I believe will provide, have a potential for mutual beneficial outcomes for both Malaysian and Philippine companies. We continued our commitment to support not only prospective Malaysian investors, but most particularly the Malaysian companies who are currently doing business as well in the Philippines already.
Marcos also sat down with key officials from FarmFresh to discuss the firm's plan to invest around $20 million to raise cattle for milk production. FarmFresh says it is looking for viable land spanning up to 400 hectares wide, and that's in the provinces of Batangas and Laguna. The firm eyes starting operations by 2028 and employ around 200 Filipinos. Marcos also met with officials from Capital A, which operates budget carrier Air Asia. Malacanang has yet to release details about that meeting.
The Asia-Pacific region will need to spend close to $145 billion for climate adaptation. That's according to the United Nations Economic and Social Commission for Asia and the Pacific. In its latest report, UNESCAP says Southeast Asia alone contributed to 24% of the total adaptation costs. It adds the Asia-Pacific region remains the most disaster-prone region in the world. In 2022, over 140 disasters hit the region, which amounted to an estimated $57 billion worth of economic damage. The agency also notes drought, intense rainfall, and floods are contributing to decreasing agricultural produce and surging food prices. Limited land supply and surging power costs. Property advisor Collier identifies these as among the issues the Philippines needs to address to become Southeast Asia's data center hub. According to Collier's report, Manila lacks viable properties that can be used for large-scale operations of data centers. This, as most land is already allocated for residential and office developments, while most existing warehouse and industrial property are geared toward manufacturing and logistics firms. The report also noted internet speed in the Philippines is still relatively slower than most of its Southeast Asian peers, while electricity costs remain to be the highest in the region. Facebook's parent Meta beats market expectations for quarterly earnings, backed by strong figures from digital ads. Meta reported a profit of $7.8 billion on $32 billion in revenue, as Facebook's monthly users rose to over 3 billion. The company said the number of ads on its various applications rose by 34% year-on-year in the second quarter. Meta had suffered a rough 2022 amid a souring economic climate and Apple's data privacy changes, which allowed users to block ad targeting. Meta shares rose more than 7% to $320.32 in after-market trades.
In today's numbers that matter, 2.3 million metric tons. That's the total number of banana exports from the Philippines last year. This was about 4% lower than the previous year's 2.4 million metric tons, according to a market review by the Food and Agriculture Organization. Now, despite this, Manila maintained its position as the second largest exporter of bananas, only behind Ecuador, which shipped around 5.8 million metric tons in 2022.
Now, the Governance Commission for Government-Owned or Controlled Corporations seeking a way to fast-track the sale of assets of abolished GOCCs. The GCG says it will submit to President Marcos a draft executive order that will institute a mechanism to ensure the effective and expeditious liquidation and winding down of these shuttered corporations. The GCG cites the lack of personnel and absence of a quorum as some of the challenges it faces in disposing the assets of 31 abolished GOCCs. The agency expects to generate at least 22 billion pesos from the sale of these assets.
Moving on from the pandemic, Filipinos are now being more mindful about their health. That's according to health and beauty retailer Watsons. Its customer director, Jared De Guzman, says despite inflationary pressures, Filipinos don't seem to be cutting on spending. But he notes items in consumer baskets have changed.
What we're definitely seeing is that, first, based on our research, a lot of the customers are moving into more mindfulness, right? And as they move towards more mindfulness, they're seeing a lot of sleep-related issues. Right. So sleep-related products, melatonin, we're definitely seeing a higher basket size on those. We're also still seeing a post-pandemic immune-boosting products that they're still consuming in the market. We're also seeing a strong growth in beauty, especially on cosmetics, fragrance, skincare, those types of categories. So it's not just mindfulness, but also using beauty for mental health.
Canadian financial services company Sun Life enters into an agreement to acquire Dialogue Health Technologies for $277 million. Dialogue is Canada's leading health and wellness virtual care platform, providing affordable and on-demand access to quality health care. Sun Life, in a disclosure to the Philippine Stock Exchange, says Dialogue's platform will help reduce the strain on the healthcare system in Canada. It adds, it is proud to invest in a Canadian company which has tremendous health expertise and incredible growth potential. Delegates begin to arrive in the Philippine province of Cebu for the third leg of the APEC Business Advisory Council meetings. Now, Annie Perez reports on the security preparations for the event.
The Police Regional Office in Central Visayas just declared today that they will be on full alert as representatives from different countries are starting to arrive now, and President Marcos Jr. is also coming to Cebu tomorrow. They will be joining the Asia-Pacific Economic Corporation, APEC, Business Advisory Council meetings, or ABAC, inside a hotel casino at the South Road properties. According to the spokesperson of PRO 7, Police Lieutenant Colonel Gerard Palare, all their personnel are maximized for the 150 delegates from 21 member economies. President Marcos Jr. is slated to deliver the keynote speech before the delegates. PRO 7 is also coordinating with other local government units involved, where the airport is Lapu-Lapu City and where they will be passing Mandawi City and where the venue is in Cebu City. The organizers are also making sure that the delegates are safe and secure as they're starting to arrive today. Hundreds of police personnel are on standby. They're coming from the regional office, Cebu City Police Office, and augmentation force from different mobile forces and other police offices. Earlier, the PNP held a send-off ceremony at their different headquarters. Pilari also said that they will have a comprehensive security within the vicinity, which will also include tourist destinations, anticipating that these participants will visit these areas, noting that Cebu and Central Visayas is considered as a tourist hub. They're also expecting the delegates to visit nearby premier tourist destinations such as the Magellan's Cross or across to Bohol. Even if they're on full alert status because of their activity, they said that their intelligence monitoring has no specific threat in regards to the particular activity. Cebu also held some APEC meetings in 2015, thereby the police said that this has been a template for them and they are ready for the event that will take place tomorrow.